Hello and welcome to Digital Classes on YouTube channel of Lalbagh Girls Inter College. I am Mrs. Paul and today's lecture is for the students of class 12th. Children, we are already doing a lesson from prose, A Girl with a Basket, written by William C. Douglas. We've already completed half of the lesson. Today we will do the remaining part. So let's see. Up till now I have told you that the author, when he got down on a station, on a platform, his routine of talking to the people got interrupted and he was surrounded by small children who were selling baskets. And he did not understand their language, but he understood their intention. These were children, refugee children. When partition between India and Pakistan was decreed, hundreds of thousands of people pulled up from their roots and changed their residences. 9 million people left Pakistan and came to India, driven by the fear of religious fanaticism. Religious fanaticism here means religious madness, children. Now he's saying that when partition between India and Pakistan was decreed, people left Pakistan. Those people who were living on the other side of the country, maybe in the cities of Lahore, Karachi or Islamabad, because that was all part of India. But as soon as it was made another nation, it was declared as Pakistan, people were forced to leave their roots, their houses, their everything that they had, and they just left everything within a night span or two, and within a day or two they packed up whatever they could and they just left. Why? Because they feared religious fanaticism, a stage when people are really mad because of religion. They are ready to kill. They will kill anybody, like children, women, old men. They will brutally murder everybody and they would molest women. So because they feared these kind of things, people left Pakistan and they came to India. But they came in huge numbers, and because they had nothing to do, they were forced to live a life of misery for a very long time. So these were children. When partition between India and Pakistan was decreed, these people came to India. They were poor people to start with. They were poorer as they began their long trek, for all they could carry was a bit of food and few belongings. Soon they were out of food. A few days after they started, they began to fall by the side from the weakness of hunger and died where they fell. This is very sad, but this has really happened in the history of India when partition was decreed between India and Pakistan, children, that children, people who were very poor, they had nothing to carry with them. For a day or two, they could carry their food, but when they were running out of food, they were weak, they were tired, they were all hungry, and when they fell down, they died there, and the rest of the people continued their long journey and they came to India, leaving them in the no man's land. So that was very sad. The children selling baskets were sons and daughters of these refugees. Now we come to know that who were these children who have surrounded the author. These were the sons and daughters of these refugees. They or their parents or relatives had gathered in the city, setting up stalls and manufacturing simple articles, trying to make a living in the markets already overcrowded. They were trying to make money for their livelihood in markets which were already overcrowded, and people were not in need of buying all the stuff that they were making. Still, they were trying with difficulty, facing hardships, to make some earnings for themselves. They lived in cloth and grass sheds that lined the streets. The peasants among these refugees had been accustomed to little all their life, for the annual income of an agricultural family does not on the average exceed $100 than $2 a week. That is, they were accustomed of living in poverty, but now they were on the verge of starvation. So they were facing a lot of problems, and that is why he is saying, because these were the people who were selling these baskets, they were too poor and to buy anything. So these markets where they were selling were not very promising markets for them, and that is why he's saying that no doubt is the reason that these little children descended on me like locust. I, an American, was doubtless the most promising market they had seen. What are they saying? They are saying that looking at him, that he was a foreigner and that he looked to them that he might have been a very rich person, they all came to him and they surrounded him and they were forcing him to buy whatever they were selling. Children, we will stop here and we will continue the lesson in the next session. And up till then, you will keep studying, you will keep doing your work. And now I am giving you assignment. The assignment for you for this particular session of mine will be that you will do the reference to the context of paragraph 2 and paragraph 3 of page number 23. Page number 23. In this book, it is page number 23. Otherwise, if you take it from the if you take it lesson wise, it would be paragraph 4 and 5. You will do the reference to context of paragraph 4 and 5, and you will show that work to me on the WhatsApp group. We will very soon meet, and we will try to complete the lesson in the next session. Up till then, goodbye, children.